Mr. Chairman, members of the board, I'm Mayor Gravitt. I'm here on behalf of myself and hopefully a lot of taxpayers and coming in Forsyth County. You know, I look at the proposed budget and looking at the millage rate increase and not taking in consideration that property values is already exorbitantly high. Obviously, we all know with the downturn in the economy, property values has plummeted, where assessments of our properties have stayed high. So with the high assessments, the county has always prided itself, especially this board, conservative board, supposedly, has prided itself that we passed a budget and we didn't have to raise your millage rate. Well, the tax assessments were reflected all of that. You didn't have to. But it's all the same, the way I look at it. It's all about money. So, as an opponent of raising property taxes and looking at the budget, I know the, in particular, the M&O budget that I look at, I know when that was took in consideration, all the properties in Cumming and Forsyth County were used. City of Cumming, Georgia, wasn't excluded from that budget. And under the M&O, none of that money is going to be used in the City of Cumming under the M&O. So I think the board hasn't accurately looked at all of the various spendings. It's easy for the board to take every department head, their request, and inflate the budget request at $93 million and say, oh, we got a $13 million deficit, and scare the taxpayers. Obviously, that's what's happened. I know there's a lot of areas that the budget can be cut. I think one of the areas in particular is a lot of the frivolous lawsuits. I just think there's a lot of lawsuits. It's unnecessary going on in the county, and a lot of money is being spent there. Another area that recently, I say recently, within the last year, I guess during the discussion of the 09 budget, I know we had a company here in Forsyth County that made a proposal to sell the county vehicle tires, and there was a company out of Hall County, Gainesville, Georgia, that also made a proposal to sell the county tires, but they were $2 more in Forsyth County than they were in Hall County. But yet the board chose to go to Hall County for this service and spend an extra $5 in gas going back and forth, plus the labor to send the vehicles over there, which made no sense to me. Spend the money at home and we collect taxes and give the people jobs here at home. To me, this board has kept spending money like they did 2 and 3 years ago and prior to that, when you were getting a lot of impact fees. Today, we don't have those impact fees. We don't have the luxury of those impact fees. 3 years ago, this board sought to put a moratorium on construction, building, so forth. The impact fees were coming in. You had more money than you knew what to do with. You didn't have to raise the millage rate. You chose to put the six-month moratorium, then chose to extend that moratorium. And then what happened? The bottom fell out of the economy. So here we are in this predicament. I say spending's out of control. Tighten your belt and live within the revenue that we collect. Thank you very much.
Anyone else wishing to speak? Is there a motion to close the public hearing?
So moved. Second.
We have a motion and a second. Please vote on the motion. And the motion passes unanimously. Any comments from the board? Any printable comments? Is there a motion to adjourn?
So moved. Second.
We have a motion and a second. Please vote on the motion. The motion passes unanimously. We are adjourned at 6:55.
Good evening, gentlemen. Dave Richard again. This is a failure of process and a failure of leadership. You worked on putting together a splossed vote to take effect a year before it even has to take place. Spent 7 months doing that. And one commissioner this evening says that he hasn't seen this map but for a week and a half. You guys going to get your priorities in shape here, in line? This is something that needs to be done in a time-sensitive manner. And you see it for a week and a half. Something's really wrong here. Some tail is wagging this dog, and it's not a pretty sight. I suggest you get your priorities together. Put the things that need to be done at the time they need to be done at the front of the list, and not the back of the list.
Thank you. Anyone else wishing to speak opposed to the map as presented? Not. Is there a motion to close the public hearing?
So moved.
Second.
There's a motion and a second. Any discussion? If not, please vote on the motion. Motion passes unanimously.
How do they know that we're operating in good faith just because we need the revenue?
Because we're the government. Yeah. We're always honest.
Go ahead. And I think that you and Bobby Amos should recuse yourself from these negotiations.
Okay. Well, you're entitled to your opinion, and I'll just refer you to my voting record for 8 years.
Not good. Well, I just, you know.
Voting record is
what it is. Wary of politicians that you don't know. And no matter what level.
Shows you the mayor's friendship.
Right? Yeah, right. And you're in, you know, with your restaurant and that the mayor owns and whatever, you know, you can't say no to them. So, and like you mentioned, as far as Amos' family, they own, you know, Boo's the property in the county. So it's understandable why you would be sticking up close to the city.
Good evening. My name is Bill Barrett. I sent y'all an email this week, and I appreciate the reply from the chairman and what have you. But I just found this water issue again. I was at the town hall meeting last week, which was quite informative and everything. But I also, not to name any names, but I just don't feel comfortable with a certain party being involved in the negotiations on this water deal, primarily because of his business dealings with the city of Cumming. And so anyway, that's, you know, my 2 cents worth. So I have, you know, I'm speaking for myself and no one else. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Is there anyone else who wishes to speak?
Julian Bowen, not speaking for anybody that lives on Coker Point Road. The way it's listed, the extension of the raw and finished water contract, of course you need to extend more, you know, the water contract. It's how you extend it that the question is. We don't have anything to comment on right now because we don't have a proposal in front of us. I've heard a lot of compromises have been proposed, but we don't have that. It's sort of like we're having a public hearing on nothing. I know of 3 different proposals that are serious proposals. I remember the proposal that Commissioner Laughinghouse sent over in 2010. That was a serious proposal. To be thrown in the trash can and laughed at was not a very responsible action. When you have proposals, you need to examine them and change them. You alternate a few numbers on a few pages, and it means a lot over a 10 or 20 or 30 year period. It's not the same situation as it was in 97, 98, and 99. You know, when you look at 6,000 building permits right down the road, the tap-on fees at $1,500, not counting business tap-on fees, you have plenty of money that you can operate with. We're looking at maybe 1,000 homes this year, last year, maybe next year. We're not in a position to offer this kind of money for basically any extended period of time. I'd like for you to have another public hearing after you have a finished document that's been agreed upon by the commissioners that we can talk about. Because right now we've got nothing to even discuss. Yeah, did I make a mistake in 97? Probably. But who knows? We don't have a proposal to compare it to. I know the mayor didn't follow the contract that another commissioner insisted that we put in about notification, prior notification, and consultation. You know, contracts are supposed to be followed. We're not the same people we were 10 years ago. I can't touch a rim anymore. You know, I did dunk on an 8-foot goal the other day, but that's not a big deal when you're 6'2 and you can reach 8'2. Nobody's the same. The county's not the same. The city's not the same. And you're acting like it's give them this, give them that, don't give them this, don't give them that. When all this needs to be carefully considered, it doesn't need to be on an emotional basis. I just think that nobody's taking this serious, and it needs to be addressed seriously, and it doesn't need to be addressed in a hostile environment like the other night. In this room, we've got total order, we've got security back there, and it needs to be carefully thought about. The city has legitimate points, and the county has legitimate points. And if we don't take it serious, and we treat it trivial, I don't see how that can exist. It almost has to be a 5-0 vote. You're going to get so much turmoil and confusion that you need to really compromise so that all five of you can agree on the situation. I hope that's something that y'all can consider. Of course, I'm fine when we talk about consensus, but on all the water contracts, it's a 5-0 vote. And that's important when you look at the future of Forsyth County and the City of Cumming. Thank you.
Well, we'll go ahead and get started here. Commissioner Tam and I spent probably the better part of 3 weeks now working on this, looking at different options, talking with the Water and Sewer Department. Just many different things, so we'll roll this out real quick. What you'll see up here now, this is the current water cost that Forsyth County pays the City of Cumming. You got the raw water formula on the left, finished water on the right. Raw water comes out after a $43.55 a month for operations. Corps of Engineer cost of power. We take that. Split up based on usage, then any maintenance and repair based on a rolling 12-month average of use comes out to about 10 cents per 1,000 gallons. Finished water, there's been contracts in place since 87. They've been amended several times. Currently, we're at 243 per 1,000 with a 1.6 billion gallon minimum purchase requirement annual. 1.6 billion, which is about 4.4 pence and change per day. But it's an annual, it's not a daily or a monthly, it's an annual purchase of $1.6 billion. What permits are, the city had built a 104 MGD, million gallons per day intake. They have a intake pipe below the sluice level of the dam, so no matter what happens with the lake level, we're still going to get water through that intake. They did that 4 years ago. They've probably spent, Brian, what, $18 to $20 million total on this?
Yeah, amazing. And at one time, they were using pumps.
Emergency pumps.
In the drought of 07, 10, 08, we were using pumps out there to get the water pumped to the intake.
Yep.
And this work took place when the lake was down. An opportunity there.
Currently, the permit that you'll see up here, Forsyth County has a permit. They're given in two numerics. It's a 14 MGD on a 30-day average. we can peak at 16 MGD within a 24-hour period. City has an 18 and 21. Combined water limits is 32 and 37 MGD, combined city and county.
Are there any other permits required or obtained from any other agencies for this intake by the city or by us?
I don't know. We use the city's intake. It's been used for...
At some point, they were permitted by the Army Corps of Engineers to build the structure because it's on Corps property. So whether or not that's an ongoing permit, I'm not prepared to speak to you right now, but they got a permit to build the structure.
My concern is certainly there is some reason to argue that there is a legal, that the capacity of the system is larger than the legal amount that can be obtained through it by the EPD. My question is, are there any hurdles of any other agency other than the EPD, including the Corps of Engineers, that would throttle the ability to take the full system capacity if it were required by either the city or us?
You mean to get to 105?
Yeah.
Well, I think that's a remain to be seen. I think given recent history, anybody who tries to pull water out of the lake is bound to be sued by somebody. I think there's a storage agreement with the Corps of Engineers.
You've got the Corps of Engineers limits that the city's got the expired storage allocation contract, and the Corps is not increasing those at the present time until Tri-State Water Board
is over. So they get an EPD increase in a permit and a storage allocation permit.
But currently the expired permit was for 10 million gallons, and right. We are in a position now where we're taking well over 10 million gallons, which was the top end of what is now an expired permit from the Corps.
From the Corps, who gave the permit to build the facility that would be capable to pull 105 million gallons back. It's government bureaucracy at its best.
I know. Anybody, living out Comfort Dam Road is you have so many governments to choose from.
They allowed that, they permitted that structure to be built. That's a fact. Another fact is...
Do you have that permit?
I didn't bring it today. Go get it.
Well,
I got a feeling...
In terms of due diligence, if there is such a thing as a physical permit...
I can tell you one thing. I can get a copy of a water contract that expires in about 6 weeks.
Well, that's 5 weeks.
Yeah, I mean, we've had that for 20 years.
25.
That wasn't really addressing my question.
I don't know how to.
We're hung up. We're at a standstill. Why don't we move forward with this? I think that the common sense answer is the Corps is allowing people to pull what they need out of there within their limits. And as soon as the Tri-State Water Wars are solved or settled, there's a lot of people that believe that Judge Magnuson's ruling was going to just shut down the Southeast, and it was overturned. So, we just got to keep going. We got to keep doing the best we can. And we can't stop what we're doing based on how you
do. We can be partners going to the EPD, the city, the county, asking for additional permits. We're working together.
So you want to join forces with the city?
It's not joining. You've got to work together. Do you not think so?
Well, I think this is working together, but I think it protects the interest of our taxpayers without putting $11.5 million out there not knowing it's safe. I would rather know that we're getting water, if there's a problem, that we can then get our own intake and be done with it, and not have wasted $11.5 million on a permit the Corps says we can't use.
Well, Mr. Tam must have agreed to an extent, because he asked him to go ahead and send it over on January 5th, and they sent it over January 6th. So, I mean, if I make a motion to
since you mentioned me by name, I asked for it, and I went and picked it up. January 5th, so we would have a starting point to talk about water.
And you must think it's a starting point, so you can't be totally against as much as Mr. Bell is.
Well, that was in January, and this is after a tremendous amount of effort.
To start this all off, I'd like to make a motion that we send this bill back over to the city, asking for fee simple ownership of the raw water intake structure that was the subject of this invoice. Invoice number 201 201-050719. Bill date was 1/05/2012, which according to this bill is now past due. It was due on 1/20/2012 for the amount of $11,436,450.13.
I think Grant and Nydia made $5.
With the response by the city within 2 weeks from today.
Because this has to do with water, and all that's going to do is inflame the situation.
Okay.
You don't need this if we work that out in my motion now.
You might be correct.
Then we're done.
That is correct. But that is correct. And especially if we go down there.
I want to tell you something. I want to tell you something. I sat at this table in 2007 where we went to court with the city of Cumming. We went to court. We lost. Did, you know why we lost?
Did it go all the way through a full trial or did they do a settlement?
I didn't say where it went. We lost. That's a fact.
By a judge's decision.
We lost. We lost. They sat here and said they'd take 9.9, we paid them 14.2. We lost. We lost.
Wait a minute.
And if you,
I don't think the city of Cumming sued this and we lost. I believe their suit was won. There was a suit by them before the election and we won that.
Then they appealed.
Don't think they did.
We gave 14.2% splits.
We That's did, a fact. But not, okay, because, but not because they sued us.
Nobody can split hairs like this group right here.
I agree.
Nobody can overlook stuff like this group right here. Either.
We paid 14.2%.
Didn't say we did.
And during that time, I just want to tell you something.
I just said they didn't sue us.
I just want to tell you, I want to finish. During that time, watching the judge, he was searching for something. He was searching to see who was operating in good faith and who was not.
I would agree with that. They always do. And if who's being reasonable, who's not being reasonable.
If you can't sit there and say to him, hey, my formula guarantees water to the citizens of the county for the next 5 years, I think that's a disservice.
What judge are you talking about?
Whoever
that he's going to be talking to about.
If we throw this into the court system, I mean, we have two choices. You either settle it or it goes to the court system. The state General Assembly doesn't do this for you. Either we settle it or goes to the court system.
Just because his position difference from yours doesn't mean, therefore, we need to start talking about we're going to court.
It's not that his position differs from mine. I'm challenging to see if he could. I asked him if he could guarantee.
And you turned whatever his answer was into, therefore we're sitting in front of a judge right now. That's a total non sequitur. Why don't you
non sequitur?
Why don't you argue the value of your position and listen to what he has to say and either fight him on against him on the value of his position rather than blowing it into some completely goofy thing like we're going to court now?
Because if we don't settle the contract, we're going to court, are we not?
I don't know, you gonna vote for that?
Yeah, and
it's a ways down the road, isn't it? If you're gonna do this, I think it covers you. And you know, you have to have, if you have, you'd rather have a drop more than a drop less. If you're gonna talk to companies about moving to the county, they can't come here and say, well, we think the city of Cumming might sell you enough water if we run out. Now this contract has been beat to death over the year. It's been to the board several times, and you know people harp on the guarantee that we have to buy water from them. But the fact of the matter is they have to provide to us. That's a guarantee also. And there's been times, correct, when we needed the water. Director of Water Service shaking his hand. We had to have the water. We have a water contract that expires in 5 or 6 weeks. This water contract, since I've been on the board, first came here in 2006, 2008, 2009, 2010. It's been here. And now it's time to send something over there.
Well,
we sent
some stuff over there before and was never responded to.
Okay. It's not my fault. So let's send it over again.
Yeah. In fact, I wasn't even implying fault. I'm just saying, We've got
an announcement that was made that if the contract expires, the raw water rate will go up. That's the that's been communicated to us. So my proposal is try to keep things, we run around and say we don't know what the Corps is going to do. We don't have their report yet. Don't know what EPD is going to do. We don't know what the Tri-State Water Board is going to do. But we do know that we have a source of water. And there are, while there are some people that feel we may be paying too much for it, we don't want people to not have the water either. So we have to find some common ground. I don't think no matter what you do, you're going to get a response by May 27th. And that by doing this, maybe throwing or making this a delicate situation difficult.
I agree.
And I think we ought to postpone this.
Postpone this item here.
That's item number two. Until we've got a contract that expires 27th, 26th. Got a work session on the work session. The first work session in June is the 12th.
All right. Of course, if you send this and you got a favorable response, obviously the change on negotiation.
That's exactly right. But like I said, I don't think you get any response in 5 weeks. Do you really think somebody's going to stop what they're doing downtown and say, oh wait, Forsyth County wants to change their allocation?
No, it's for the future. We understand that that worked out fast.
Okay, so
but we might as well get it started. We should have done this 2 years ago. A year ago.
You think it's 25?
Yeah.
I think you're in the middle of negotiations. Again, if and when we ever go to court, if we were to go to court, do you think this is operating good faith?
I think it's operating in the best interest of the county.
But yeah, it is. It aligns itself.
I think at this time, postpone it until May or June the 12th.
Why don't you make a motion about that?
I do.
It aligns itself with the bill that was sent in.
Second.
Matter of fact, not even second. With the bill. According to the bill, we should have $24 million a day, but this is only asking for 21. Seems very good faith.
We have a motion and a second.
65%.
Todd, we have a motion and a second.
On.
Postpone it? For June the 12th, which is the next work session after the water contract expires.
Is there any further discussion? If not, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign.
Aye.
That's a procedural motion. That's defeat.
Therefore, I would like to make a motion to send this resolution to over to the city.
Why are we? I said it. We're voting
down. I'm sorry.
We're
to the EPD.
Here.
Yeah. To the EPD.
The resolution requesting Georgia Environmental Protection Division reallocate the existing surface water withdrawal permits between Forsyth County and the City of Cumming. It's no different than what the bill they said. They said we're 65% users. This doesn't even ask for that much.
Do I hear a second?
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 All those opposed, like sign.
Aye.
And that is 2-2.
That is that's a substantive motion, a main motion, and therefore the tie works to move it to the next agenda where the tie can be broken. Which would be whenever a fifth member can vote on this topic.
I watched our government up close for many years, and frankly, I've lost faith in the system. I've looked on as these supposed public servants serve their own special interests instead of the interests of the taxpayers. I've watched as they squander our money foolishly, betray our trust, and use their positions to improve their own personal lives and fortunes and not that of the citizens. A true leader doesn't resort to bullying, and a true leader knows you must show respect to your constituents and to your fellow board members in order to be effective. When your commission meetings begin to mimic a Jerry Springer show, you're in trouble, and I want it to stop. I'm not a politician, but I am a citizen that cares about our county because it's something I have been so proud of my entire life. It's where I come from. And I'm very proud of the district that was, that my family's eight generations into that district.
That's why I think folks is upset between the county and the city, because the county ain't got a clue what's going on until it's done passed. And then you go, what? And that's the way it is, and that's why there's trouble right now between the county and city, because it's just like, I didn't know that. And we need to get this set down and have a meeting to get everybody together and on one page and let the people know.
I applaud the Tea Party for the way they've been sending people to meetings and watching, because it can make us all be better as public servants, the more people engage in the process and the more that they watch what's going on. It's a lot of money. It needs to be watched. And I think any time that you can, people know they're being watched, it's good. And that's why I started the focus on Forsyth Side when I did. And I just think that it's good for people to know what's going on. I think that it's very important for a board to be united, especially when you're going, I think that you can watch the mayor and how he works with his city council. And I think he's in 40 some odd years, he's had one no vote. And I think that we can't hardly agree on anything. And it's, we need to be united. We need to have five county commissioners that represent the county and the county's interests.
Chief Tatum, if you would remove the camera from the auditorium. We don't allow filming inside of the city hall again unless there's specific reasons. So if you would remove the camera.
You're gonna have to move outside.
That's the reason we don't have Comcast up here on the wall. We don't allow that anymore.
Respectfully, Mayor, Georgia
it's
Sunshine
not a discussion. Law. Could I have the camera removed, please?
No, sir. Georgia law, I'm exercising my right as a citizen to record this meeting.
You're, sir,
this is an open and public meeting. I have a right by Georgia law
step
to
outside.
Film this meeting. Ask Dana Miles.
Contact
ask your counsel. Ask Dana Miles.
You're certainly able to record it.
I have a right by Georgia law. There will be a complaint filed with Georgia Attorney General not allowing me to film this meeting.
Okay.
Take your hands off of me.
Don't file your complaint.
Take your hands
step
off
outside.
Of me, sir. Let me get my bag. I'm sorry.
I'll get ma'am.
You are violating Georgia state law. Open and which?
You're certainly able to record it.
Oh, okay. Very well.
Yeah.
This is illegal. You cannot close a meeting. I have a right by Georgia law, and you should consult your counsel, Dana Miles. He is aware of Georgia state law.
Come on. He's finished.
I'm ready to start the meeting.
Okay, I'll turn it off.
We have two public comment speakers signed up this evening. Our first speaker is Robert Bork.
My name is Bob Gork, and I live in District 2 of Powell Creek Way. And I'm speaking for myself, and I have no pending matter in front of the county. I want and deserve total transparency from my board of commissioners. Given the information I obtained from an open records request from the City of Cumming, I'm going to ask the commissioner to recuse himself from all IGA discussions and votes until the end of his term for the following reasons. On April 1, 05, City of Cumming entered into a legal agreement for a retail lease with Schoolhouse Holdings, LLC. Personally, I have almost 10 years of experience of executing literally hundreds of retail leases throughout the Southeast for a major retail corporation. I understand that what would be typical and atypical provisions in a retail lease. For my provisions, I have found that Schoolhouse Holdings retail lease that I have reviewed is not a typical retail lease. It is not typical that a retail lease that spans from April 2005 until March 2016 with renewals that receives no increases in rent over an 11-year period, that is not typical. It is not typical that no early lease termination fees are imposed in the agreement. With no early termination provision in this lease, it is not a typical lease. It is not typical that a lease contains no late penalty fees for paying your rent 5 or 10 days late within the month that the rent is due. According to the own city's records, the leaseor has been late past the 5 or 10 day grace period in the past 15 of the 16 months, many times exceeding 4 to 6 weeks past due. It is not typical. It is not standard business practice to have all water, electric, and HVAC included in a retail lease cost. In this case, the retail lease cost from lease inception with renewals through 2016 is $2,500 a month, including all utilities. It is not a standard business practice in a retail lease to require only a $500 deposit to lease the place, but usually a month's rent. This is not a typical lease. It is not typical for a landlord or a leasor to agree to conduct, and I quote exactly from the lease, promotion of the cafe where possible and appropriate in conjunction with theater activities for the tenant. This is not typical. It is not typical for a landlord to allow the open-ended use of additional rooms for catering activities at no additional cost without agreeing to the estimated usage rates in the lease agreement. It is not typical for a landlord to purchase and install awnings, flooring, window treatments, and new doors without specifically identifying tenant improvement dollars as on a per square foot allowance combined with an amortization schedule against future rent payments. This is not a typical lease. So I ask that the commissioner would agree that he can't be objective in any IGA discussions or votes and should recuse himself. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
To vote on it tonight?
Well, they haven't even met on the board. And even though you say you spoke with the mayor, he doesn't have the authority to board.
So, well, have you ever watched the votes over there? I don't think anyone's ever voted against the mayor.
I was telling you, we agreed to extend, then we sent over an offer, and they have not met to discuss our offer.
I thank all of you being with us. Recognize Commissioner Bale, Commissioner Amos, Commissioner Boff. Thank all of you for being with us. And all of the dignitaries that are here tonight. We appreciate you coming to see us. Would you come in for them? Okay, under old business, there being none. Under new business, the add-on. Items as we receive them, Mr. Brad Meadows, we have the first speaker tonight. By the way, how much time do we need?
I need about an hour and a half. I'm just joking, Mayor. I only need about 2 minutes.
Okay, 2 minutes. Mr. Snyder?
2 minutes.
Okay. All right, thank you.
Mayor, City Council, and allowing us to speak here to take some very important actions potentially this evening. I brought to you at the last meeting some concerns about the legitimacy of this body, specifically under Georgia Code 21-2-291. It specifically spells out under statutory and legislative action for provisions for you to follow if you're unopposed. I believe that that law, particular law 21-2-291, was not followed. In that law, it says that if there is an issue submitted before the electorate, which there was, that being SPLOS, that each of you gentlemen should have been on the ballot and you should have had votes cast for you. There were no votes cast for you. So I bring to you a concern about the legitimacy of this body before you take on important actions. If you would, please consider going before the Attorney General, the Secretary of State, and asking for them to have a clarification of that. Also, I would ask that all of you gentlemen, please be prepared for the loss negotiations, and also there's training available for the loss negotiations provided by the state of Georgia. So when we get to the point of local option sales tax splits, I hope that each of you will know exactly what the law is relative to local option sales tax splits and negotiations between the city and the county. I appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Mr. Schneider.
Good evening. My name is Hal Schneider. I'm a resident of Forsyth County. Thank you for allowing me to speak. I just want to talk to you a little bit about the water contract negotiations. And to ask that all of you take the time to review the lawsuit between the City of Falls Church, Virginia, and the County of Fairfax, Virginia. In that lawsuit, it was ruled that the City of Fairfax, or the City of Falls Church, could not charge the county any more than the actual cost for water that the city provided to the county. I know that the proposal that the city has submitted to the county is raising the raw water rate from 10 cents per gallon to 50 cents per gallon for some period of time, and then it raises to 75 cents per gallon. That's a 7.5 times increase over what the city charges today. And it would behoove this body, as well as the city attorney, to review the lawsuit that I mentioned earlier, because based on that precedent, the city would be breaking the law in that they would be taxing the county residents without representation. That's what the ruling of the judge and the court in Virginia was. So I would urge you all to take a look at that lawsuit. Thank you very much.
Question, Mr. Snyder.
Yes.
First of all, we are a city that provides water, not only for the City of Cumming, but we have about two-thirds of the city customers is outside of the corporate limits of the city. My question is, do you think air water is worth as much as the surrounding cities and counties' water?
I think your water is worth what the county of Forsyth is able to produce treated water at, and that's 52 cents per thousand gallons. So to answer your question though, the cost of the raw water is only worth what it costs you to pump it out of the lake and deliver it to the Forsyth County treatment plant. Whatever that cost is for you to pump the water from point A to point B, that's your cost. And according to this lawsuit, that's the only thing you're allowed to recover is your cost for doing that.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Now, if we're going to have quality water for our homes and businesses and coming in for South County, furnished by a state-of-the-art facility of the intake in Lake Lanier that was recently completed, and every step of the way the commissioners were involved in it, even members of the commissioners were carried over and given a tour of the facility. The additional water treatment facility, state-of-the-art, the city and county facilities wins state and national awards of the best water for this size of city and county in the state of Georgia. These facilities has got to be paid for. And it's my understanding, and looking at county's budget, that the water that the city sold the county last year current rate, the county profited $16 million. The city's budget is only $12 million. So the county made more money off of the water that the city sold them than their budget is. So who's making all the money? County says that they want to have ownership of part of the intake facility. Well, to my knowledge, the federal government, the Corps of Engineers, has never deeded anybody in the property of Lake Lanier. You might get a permit, but you don't get deeds to it. See that we have a lot of distinguished guests here with us today. Recognize Commissioner Tam, Commissioner Boff, Commissioner Amos, and certainly all of your distinguished guests. We're glad to have all of you here with us. This was a special call meeting. Again, as I was saying, this was a special call meeting for the consideration of the proposal that the county sent to the city May the 18th, reference to the city-county water contract. The difference is the one that was sent May the 7th and the one that was sent May the 18th. This is binding, and the May 7th was a binding contract. This contract has a certain, has five additional terms with it, and certainly as the non-binding proposal, this one here to me is actually worse than the other. There's five additional terms. One of them was added in that the county has no legal obligation to pay the city the portion that they've been invoiced on the treatment, on the intake in Lake Nydia. So my first request to the city that I would, to the council, I'd recommend that their proposal of May the 18th be rejected. Chair will entertain a motion.
Make a motion.
Second. A motion from Rubin, second from Lewis. In discussion. Please vote, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. The city submitted a proposal May the 7th to the county, and of course it was rejected. The city has taken that proposal and tweaked it a little bit. The proposal is basically for treated water at 225,000 gallons. For a 5-year contract, and which we think is certainly a fair, more than fair deal. We have also given them on the raw water. I might also add that we tweaked the treated water. It had a 3-tier, 225 for the first 3,330,000 gallon a day. We put that on the monthly average at 225. The $2.40, the middle tier was taken out, and it's $3.50. Anything over the 3,330,000 gallon on a monthly average. So the middle tier is taken out of the non-binding, out of the city's contract, which was binding. The raw water pumping from Lake Lanier to the county's treatment plant, it basically stayed the same, and it's for a 10-year agreement. The county had requested at one time a 50 years, a 25 years, a 15 years. So this is a contract that we feel is on the raw water is extremely fair. There's been an interim study of 18 cities and counties surrounding Cumming and Forsyth County. And Cumming and Forsyth County water rates are the cheapest of those 18 surrounding cities and counties. The average cost of those 18 cities and counties per 1,000 gallon is $5.39. Now the city is proposing $2.25 a 1,000 gallon. And that's a 5-year fixed rate. So we think the city's price is very fair, more than fair. So we have a proposal here, and I might add that this proposal is coming at the end of a 25-year working relationship with the city and county on the contract that was entered into in 1987. And this 25-year expires this Saturday. And with this proposal, if the county has any intentions of trying to resolve this and want to sign off on this binding contract, and maybe it can be tweaked a little bit with the county's input in the next couple of days, but if they have any intention to tweaking the contract, I apologize. Attorney General, I don't know if we have a legal meeting. Anyway, if the county wants to work on this for the next couple of days, I'll be available Wednesday and Thursday. Friday's out of the picture. I'm busy all day, and of course, the contract expires on Saturday. So with that said, the council has copies of the proposal that's been worked up, and the chair will entertain a motion if the county and the cities wants to submit this binding proposal to the county. And by the way, this can be submitted later on today to the county for their consideration. I understand they have a meeting this afternoon.
I'd like a motion to approve the contract.
I have a motion from Lewis to send the contract to the county as it's been presented. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Now, what I'd like to ask the council, in view of the fact that I will not call another special meeting tomorrow or Wednesday or Thursday, which contract is set to expire. Does the council
I have a motion to that
see effect that they want to authorize me to negotiate with the county and sign off if they
want to say that? I make a motion that if there's any small tweaking to the what we're sending them, we authorize you to make that and sign off on it. And that's my motion.
Have a motion from Lewis to have a second.
Second.
Any discussion? Please signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. I hear a motion to adjourn.
Back motion.
Second. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
All are present other than Commissioner Levent. Do we want to call Commissioner Levent? Todd?
Yeah.
Can you hear us? This is Jim Boff.
Hey,
we're just about to adopt or make modifications and then adopt the agenda. We thought we could get you on in case there was anything you wanted to change. So we'll go ahead with the adoption of the agenda if that's okay.
Chairman, just to confirm, Commissioner Levent, where are you? Yes, we have the jurisdiction. Where are you right now?
Kansas.
That's out of the jurisdiction.
Somewhere here, Jeff Johnson, Kansas.
I don't even know what your motion is, to be honest with you. Restate it.
The motion is to purchase 1.2 billion of finished water annually, 225 per 1,000 gallons, 5-year initial term, 5-year renewal. Raw waters, the 10 cents per 1,000 gallons. I didn't say it, but I would assume it was 20-year term.
20-year term, Todd?
It was 5 and 5 on finished, and it was 20 on raw.
Then there was $11,400,000 outright for the intake, with a commitment for 65% of future EPD permanent allocation, 65% storage allocation in Lake Nydia.
Thank you, Todd. Do you remember in one of these marathon sessions that we've had before that we've been told that a payment of $11.4 million out of the Water and Sewer Authority will jeopardize our capital improvement? Do you remember that?
I've also heard them say it would on a one-on-one conversation.
Well, will it jeopardize our capital improvement plan, Tim?
Sorry.
If we pay $11.4 million, will it or will it not? I mean, I just remember you said it would jeopardize. We'd have to rework our capital improvement plan.
I was told there was nine.
We're carrying nine in there, in the CIP.
We carry $9 million in there?
Yes, we put nine in there. So that would be the same. I think we had concerns about having to capitalize payments in a year in the operational budget. Mr. Bruin could better answer the financial part of it as far as...
Speaking of finances, I just want to do something real quick. Go back over to the finished and just carry it on down 5 more years.
This one?
1.2. Just see what that looks like.
The problem is not whether or not the 1.2, 1.6 will give us enough. If you use it in your summer months and your hot months when you need it, it is enough. But when you're forced to buy it in the winter months, leaving your late spring, summer, and early fall, it's a short shift.
Todd, that any of the finished water can be taken down as we need it?
Well, tell me how many gallons out of it a day if you do it in 180 days.
Well, I don't think we need to get into trying. I think it's dangerous to try to determine when we may or may not need it, when we can currently take it down whenever we need it.
Since I'm not there and I haven't had anybody run numbers for me yet, do you all mind telling me what 1.2 billion gallons on an annual basis is divided by 180 days? How many millions of gallons is that per day?
It's about 6 million a month, 6.5, right?
6 days.
It's half of the 1.2 billion. Because right now our average is 12.2 right. a month. We didn't go on vacation though, Todd. We're here to work.
1.2 billion divided by 180 days.
180 days is 6 months.
That's your hot month. That's your months we need the extra water.
Why not put it to when we can get it whenever we need it?
That's the way we have it.
The number runs, Mr. Bell.
It says 6.66 million gallons a day.
So 6.6. Right.
Or on top of the 14, that's only 20 to 21. That's going to be tight. I agree. So do we now go back and...
Why don't you just go back to the 1.6?
Sorry? Why can't we put a cloth in there just so additional raw water?
Well, we the 6.5 million was 50-50. We could make it either or, except
I'll tell you what let's do, Todd. I got an idea. Put it back at 1.6 and ask them to make us a condition that they make available an additional 6.5 million gallons a day on a 30-day average of raw water.
So you're going to raise it up 1.6 to, 1.2 to 1.6 and put in the 6 million day on top of that again?
That is what.
It's 6.5 of raw.
I said raw. 6.5 of raw.
Minimum.
Oh, that works.
1.6.
So that's 1.6.
It's rounded off.
And they make available an additional 6.5 million gallons a day on a 30-day average of raw water.
Off of their permit.
I don't care whose permit it's off of.
Listen, you can't tell them to make available. They're already making our 14 available. You're asking them to change it, or is it going to be additional to our 14 permit?
I got the 1.6 million.
Go ahead. Hold on.
1.6 million, 10 years at 225. So where did we start?
That's what he said.
Five. And then, well, it may show five or show. Should show five or show 10 here?
Show 10.
10 cents?
It's actually 10.3 and a half cents.
I thought it was 10.8.
10.8, 10.3, something like that. What is it?
You better just put in 10.8 so we don't have to come back and go through this.
That's fine.
That way we'll have less accurate smoke and mirrors.
Oh, look at that. We're saving $7.5 million.
Same thing.
It's the same thing.
That's because I get caved in and I give you your
money. No, let's just do it. To pay the 11, so it'll cost us 3.
Is the 11 in there?
No.
Okay.
So when we do that, Todd, and pay the 11, it's costing us $3 million more than what we're doing now.
Is that what you want to do, Todd?
It's the 20-year water deal. If you calculated it over 20 years,
no, that's
still shutting it down at 10 in your numbers.
That's
you
10.
Come up with that difference.
That's 10.
All right. Well, of course, if you wean yourself off of the finished water,
correct,
you're going to have a reduction. But that's the unknown. That's the unknown. You just don't know.
That's why I want to do 5 and 5. You may be able to wean yourself off of 5. But if you can't, you need the water, you've got the available additional 5-year deal. So if you add it into your numbers, yes, it's going to show it.
Right. So, just so I'm clear on what you want to make, you want to make sure that they keep the plant operational, equipped, and staffed if we want to use it.
Yeah, they're going to need finished water no matter what.
Just like we need to keep ours.
Right. I mean, tell me what days they won't need finished water.
They are going to need finished water, but they're going to need that additional 4.5 million gallons a day.
Well, how would we know that?
City.
If we go to buy water from Cherokee County, what do they want from us? They want us to invest in their infrastructure, right? Mm-hmm. That's the only way we get water from them.
Pay a higher price. You don't.
And you pay a higher price.
You can get it without a higher price, or you pay capital and get it for a lower price.
But we're willing to do that. It's okay.
It's okay.
We've sat here for another 2 hours.
Okay, I'm going to make a motion, Todd. I'm going to help us all out here, okay?
Commissioner Tam, just one second. Cindy, where are we? We have a motion and second on the table.
We have a motion and second on the floor.
Okay, and that is for what?
I believe it was for $1.2 billion on an as-needed basis, $225 per thousand, five-year renewal, 10 cents per thousand for 20 years on raw, pay 11.4 for the intake with the 65% allocation. That's on the table right now. Your 6.5 30-day average is not part of that motion.
Right.
So that's the motion and second on the table right now.
I didn't hear it real good. You read back mine, is that what you're doing?
Yes, sir. That's right.
Todd, if you'll think about withdrawing your motion, I'll make one that you might like.
Okay, my motion is withdrawn.
Now the second needs to withdraw their second.
I withdraw it.
My second withdrawn motion is withdrawn.
Okay. I'm going to make a motion that we renew the contract, finished water contract as is, resetting the price down to $225.
How long are you renewing it for, please?
5 years with a 5-year option.
On the finished?
On the finished water.
Okay, on finished water, okay.
That we pay the $11.4
million. Mm-hmm.
That we pay the or that we do the raw water at 10.8 cents a thousand.
Okay.
Well, just
go ahead. Let's just be clear that it's 10.8 based on what it's really our percentage
of the wheeling fee
of the total.
We understand that. We've discussed that a bunch.
Tim, is 10.8, you think that's accurate?
It changes every month, so I mean, you know, but that's what had been out for a few months, average. So it's current contracts up and down.
Yeah.
That's going to get you in the ballpark.
That they make available 6.5 million gallons a day, and I don't know, will that fit in their permit, Tim?
It depends on how much they need on it.
Hold on just a second. Will it fit in there?
I don't know. I don't know what their max days are. They've been giving us.
Yeah, but the 6.5 is a 30-day average.
Yeah, but look, how can they commit, if all of a sudden they need a lot of water, how can they commit to the 6.5?
Because the language we've always used is so long as it doesn't.
If it's including this 1.628 billion, if that
we don't need 6.5. Is that what you're saying?
That would be, you know, about six, at times during this we get 6.5 from, maybe 7 occasionally, but.
Yeah, but not 6.5 more.
Your question,
not
they six, probably cannot do 6.5.
Your question, will that eat into their allocation?
Okay, so what he's saying, I think, is that's 4.5 million a day. We need another 2 million a day. Is that right?
To get us to what we're doing today and then raw water addition, yes.
So if I'm hearing you correctly, we need to ask them to make available to us another 4.5. We'd be comfortable with that, if I'm understanding that correctly.
I think so, yes.
So, Todd, you see we took it down a little because we're buying more fish.
On top of this,
I understand.
So, my motion then is that they make available an additional 4.5 million per day of raw water available to us.
Okay.
Okay.
And it's over and above our permit, right?
Yeah.
It needs to be clear that they're over and above our permit.
Well, yeah, if they're making it available to us, it's their permit.
Okay.
All right, but we're guaranteeing the 1.6.
We're buying 1.6.
We're guaranteeing it.
Yes.
Okay.
We're guaranteeing it. And that this be on the raw 15 and a 15-year option.
On the raw 15 and 15?
Yep.
5 and 5 on the finished?
Yep.
Okay.
That's my motion.
And is that CPIU on both or not?
Yes.
A time sensitive commission?
Time sensitive. Call the meeting tomorrow, the next day, Friday. I don't care.
Second.
Jim, you get it? You understand it?
Yeah, I'll say this. Currently, the contract, we can't renew the current one and without a 4% cap on the CPIU because the current one has a 4% cap per year on the CPIU.
Well, that's fine.
Okay, so you take that CPI stuff off that's already in the contract.
That's part of the as-is, in the existing contract.
That's in the contract.
Do we want to consider?
Hold on just a second. The CPI is in my motion. And the 4.5, if that makes him comfortable, can be in my motion too.
And I'll second that.
Well, I thought your motion was for finished water as is under the existing contract, but yeah. 5 and 5.
As is under the existing contract has a CPI.
Contains CPI, that's what I'm saying.
Yes,
4%
but
he wants a 4% cap.
No, the current contract has a 4% cap.
Okay, that's fine. Yeah. Okay. No objection there.
That's fine. Do we want to consider preserve some of the cash on hand of trying to figure out how to add something and let
Listen, it, if this is what it takes, yeah. This is what it takes.
Todd?
Yes.
You think you understand the motion?
I do. Are we 1.2 or 1.6?
1.6.
So can I ask one question, please? Earlier in the first motion, gentlemen made was 1.2 with the additional 6.5. How come then that was enough water and now it's not?
Oh, he is hung up. He's going to sit here and answer that like
you
did there.
No, I'm not. Just asking what the difference is
in
your motion now.
Because it's...
What made you realize all of a sudden it wasn't enough?
That's a fair question.
I don't know that it... Okay. We went from 1.2 to 1.6.
No. Earlier, your first motion,
yeah,
respectfully, was for 1.2, and you added the additional 6.5, was it not?
Yes.
Okay, that was going to be enough water then. Now it's not enough water unless you do the 1.6 with the 6.5 million additional.
I didn't say 6.5, Todd.
No?
No. I said 4.5, and I said make it all wrong.
Oh, got you. Okay, very good. I got it.
There was no smoke, no mirrors.
Got you. Thank you.
Didn't I?
Yep.
Yeah. Yep. Somebody's nodding their head. That's a good sign.
Yeah,
that means vote for it, Todd.
I can't see them, though. It's like I'm blind.
Cindy wants you to vote for it.
We didn't go on vacation, Todd.
She's just about done with her book. Okay.
Yeah. We have a motion, I believe.
And a second.
And we have a second. And I guess I'll...
Hey, what are we doing on the 1.4?
It's in there.
We're paying it. Because that's what you want to do.
Yes.
It's not yes.
Because you're in Kansas.
But we have lifetime access, correct?
Lifetime.
In the motion?
That was lifetime.
That wasn't in the motion. Lifetime.
We need to get that in the motion. We have lifetime access.
How do you go lifetime access? How do you go from 10 years to lifetime or 15 years to lifetime access?
Illusionally on this one.
Okay, when you were at 20 years, were you at lifetime access?
He was.
If I asked him for ownership of retaining for 65% of the infrastructure,
okay,
redo,
let's
we have access to it for lifetime.
All right.
For that 65%.
And your motion, this is Ken, your motion did not contain the language about the permit allocations.
It's in.
Aye.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's it.
That's a given.
That's for Ken's motion. Mine's gone.
That would be the yada, yada, yada.
Okay.
That's a given, Todd, those permit allocation language. That's a given.
Okay, I didn't understand that. Commissioner, did you hear that?
Well, as long as you believe the motion can be done, you'll have a given.
Well, now that it's been said on the record, I'm comfortable adding that, yes.
Excellent, thank you.
So you're comfortable seconding that, Patrick? We might be getting somewhere, Todd.
We might be getting somewhere, sir.
All right.
We have a motion and a second.
We have a motion and a second. Todd, do you feel that you
don't know
enough to be able to vote? Todd?
Yeah.
Okay. That we have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. That passes 4-0 with Commissioner Amos refused.
We've done this 4 years ago.
Can we have this over there by noon tomorrow?
We'll have it by noon tomorrow.
So when are we going to have our celebration? Crackers with cheese and
after they accept it.
After they accept it.
Oh, we get
it. So that's just a small little component.
I'd like to call the special call of the work session Thursday, May 24th, 2012, of the Forsyth County Board of Commissioners. In order, please.
You're continuing to try to kind of news on the wastewater plant, but you're not addressing the real problem.
With
us, it's not
waiting for something?
Yeah. Well, I think we're waiting for a document. But
we're not waiting for a document.
Call it.
Spring call, Mr. Van.
It's Todd here.
Okay, we're back together, and I guess the time has elapsed for waiting for something, Ken.
Do we need to officially reconvene?
Yeah, let's go ahead and call it to order, just announce the time, and we come out of recess. You know, not recess.
We never took a recess.
We've just been waiting for the City of Cumming to provide any feedback with respect to the last proposal, the binding proposal we had sent to them.
It is my understanding that they have accepted the proposal as is with no modifications, and that written confirmation of that is on its way across the street even as we speak. Mr. Chairman, I might recommend that we wait another 3 or 5 minutes just to see that in writing, put it into the record. But if it says what it is reported to have said, then I'll just need to get to work putting together IGA with the city attorney.
Okay. So we're back into kind of a wait mode here?
That's right, although I think that's a significant piece of information. But yes, I would prefer to see the written document.
Yes. Todd, you want us to call you back again?
Yeah, that'd be great. Thank
I don't
you.
Think you need to wait.
But I did hear that they accepted everything as is, correct?
That's okay. What we think.
That's what we think.
We're waiting on the written confirmation.
Very good. I'll be waiting for your phone call back.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, I'm going to go just run out and see if it's at the reception desk.
We're not done yet, though.
We just won. We've got the part there.
Kim Gerard, City of Cumming?
Yes.
Correct.
You don't have to sit in the corner.
Sit with us.
You can sit up there.
That's, you get paid more. Place. You get paid more.
Really? Speaking of that, can we talk after this meeting and see what your rates are and everything?
I'm afraid there are too many things I would have to complete out of. Did I get your sim? Okay. I saw it. Yeah, congratulations. How big?
It's probably a blue
board or something.
Kevin's here or something. Oh, would you call Todd again, Doug, please? I'm sorry to say.
He saw me.
You get me one. I'm running over here. I don't know.
Well, I guess the word
we
have to
work. That's a good
location. Hey, Todd. We we're coming back together. Ken just handed out a letter from the city. Ken, you want somebody to read it?
Mr. Chairman, I'll just read it quickly into the record. This letter was just hand-delivered by the attorney for the City of Cumming. It's to the county manager of the City of Cumming is in receipt of your proposal of general terms dated May 22nd, 2012. I am pleased to inform you that the City of Cumming can agree to those terms, subject to counsel for the city and the county putting said general terms into an intergovernmental agreement for ratification of both government authorities.
Okay, Ken, are you sitting your seat or closer to the speaker?
All right, 1 second.
Come on up here.
Commissioner Levent, just very briefly, the letter states, the letter states the City of Cumming is in receipt of your proposal of general terms dated May 22nd, 2012. I am pleased to inform you that the City of Cumming can agree to those terms, subject to council for the city and the county putting said general terms into an intergovernmental agreement for ratification by both governing authorities. I thank you for your efforts in this matter and look forward to seeing the final version of this agreement completed. Sincerely, H. Ford Gravitt, Mayor of the City of Cumming. So I believe that that draws this matter, at least for purposes of today. I mean, I'll of course defer to the board, but I believe that draws this matter to a close.
I would like to see how the verbiage works out if I agree from the final verbiage of the IGA.
Well, the material elements of any IGA will match what was taken across the street.
Excellent.
Do we need a motion? Just a motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn.
I mean, it goes without saying, I'll be working with the attorney for the city to put together an IGA and bring it back to you in a meeting.
Very good.
Tisdale? Do we have a motion?
A motion to second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Pose like sign. And we are adjourned at 12:40 p.m.
We have one public comment speaker signed up this evening. That speaker is Rebecca Ricks.
Good evening, gentlemen. I'm here again tonight to speak on the lost facts in hopes that anyone that is doing business with the City of Cumming would recuse themselves. As we most of us are aware, the City of Cumming receives 15% of the loss, and they only have a little over 3% of the population of the county. So I am asking again, and I will be back to ask again, that if you are doing business, personal business, with the city, that you recuse yourself. The citizens of Forsyth County deserve that. Thank you, Jim.
Thank you. We're on to old business. Boat washing sales tax renegotiation update from the county manager.
Chairman, members of the board, you may recall June 26th work session, the board approved initiating renegotiations with the city for lost to begin June 27th, 2012. County senior staff has met with city senior staff. The city did share with us their position regarding the percentage of split. The city provided us with a document, and that document also is in your package, and that document basically summarizes their position on a few items that they spell out. One is the central business district, the other is lowering property tax burden and daytime population. That's the only document that we've gotten from the city to date to work from. We are, however, approaching the deadline for renegotiating the split during the first phase of this process. The next phase of negotiation is known as alternate dispute resolution, and you may know it as being a non-binding mediation phase. If an agreement is not reached during the first phase, which we are in today, direct renegotiations, then law requires that parties submit immediately to non-binding arbitration, mediation, or another alternate dispute resolution. Also, would the board like to begin the process of discussing and selecting a mediator? I would assume that might be done at the county attorney level, along with the city's attorney, to discuss the selection of the mediator, if in fact you go in that direction. Chairman?
Yes, sir. Thank you. If I understood what you said towards the beginning there, I think I heard you say that at least cursory numbers, I assume, expressed as a percentage of the loss split, were discussed or mentioned by the city side of the conversation. Can you tell us what those numbers were?
I can. The city's position, at least at staff level, senior staff level, was a split for the city at a range of between 15 and 25% of the split.
15 to 25% lost.
Yes, of the loss.
Of the loss, thank you. Yes. And on the other hand, or as a data point, let's say that as one data point, we have information here that shows that the tax digest value of all the property in the city of Cumming compared to the tax digest value, I guess, of everything in the county, yields a 3.94% of the value in view that way. Do I have that right?
You have it correct.
Okay. So we're, the idea that we may go to negotiations or further is potentially incorporated or insinuated with the possible difference of 3.94% versus 15 to 25%. I'm not saying that that is the only way to look at it, but I'm saying with the information provided here, those are two gross, well-defined, although perhaps coarse data points to look at.
You are correct, and as you said earlier, that is one of the data points we would be evaluating. Yes, sir.
Councilor, question, please.
Sir.
In the law that describes the negotiation, is there a difference on the definition of daytime or nighttime population? What does the law, how does the census view that population? Is there a difference for this?
Yeah, the actual statute does not speak in terms of daytime and nighttime population. And remember when we sort of went through our, we had like two primers on loss. The eight criteria set forth are simply things to be considered, but it says are not limited to those things. So what I can tell you, Commissioner LeMann, is while the statute does not say daytime versus nighttime, to the extent that one party wanted to bring that issue to the table and say that is important to them, I don't think it would be by any stretch precluded or forbidden, but it is not spelled out specifically that is a factor to consider at all.
Populations are done by the census, correct?
They are.
And does the census have a separation of daytime or nighttime? Or do they just consider your residence where you live?
I believe it is simply a function of where there is residence, not as far as a daytime and nighttime population. But I was going to finish by saying, if you bear down into the data far enough, into some of the data points way down deep, it may very well, I'm not sure I'm qualified right now to say.
Okay,
the Census Bureau does have they don't provide daytime and nighttime population, they do provide two formulas for arriving at that point.
Those formulas include weekends?
I don't think this gives a value of taking the through the ACS, the American Consumer Survey, Consumer Community Survey, and takes those numbers to date from it.
Did the city offer in any way other evidence or evidence derived from the daytime, nighttime population that would suggest where on the split that they offered, I guess, was 12.5% to 25%, did I get that number right?
15 to 25%.
Why such a wide, that's almost 100%, or nearly a doubling of the low end number to arrive at the top end number. Any pointers as to what would cause a person to say, well, 15 looks a lot more right than 25?
Chairman, they did not. In fact, the meeting that we, they provided the 15 to 25% different, in fact, from the information that you got here in this document. The third bullet point there is the state of population. When they presented to us their range, there was no discussion at that time that I can recall about daytime population. If there was, it was not directly related to or associated with their range for the split.
Chair, I just wanted to mention to you along the lines of what the county manager just said, as we get closer to the automatic drop-off point to go into the formal mediation process, I think the work session would be in order to perhaps go through some of this in some roll-the-sleeves-up detail, because there's a host of issues right now involving the City of Cumming for which we need, you know, some movement.
Forsyth County Water Interim Agreement Proposal. First of all, over the last couple of years, the water proposals have been tossed around from the city to the county, the Facebook, the website, just about anybody that you want to talk to will talk about the water proposal. How maybe the city's getting ripped off, or how maybe the county's getting ripped off by the contract that expired May the 26th. But keep in mind that this contract had worked very well over the years. It was entered into in 1987, amended in 97. The county had never been out of water in that 25 years. City was able to facilitate a wastewater treatment plant, work with the county on that agreement within the contract. But May the 26th of this year, that contract expired. Prior to then, we were working to try to negotiate, come up with an agreement, and the county sent, on May the 23rd, the Board of Commissioners sent the city a one-page agreement to the water contract, to renew the water contract. And this agreement was basically a letter of intent, because the agreement that they sent over, or the proposal that was sent over, was followed up the next day by a letter: if you agree to this, it's got to come back before the Board of Commissioners for approval. So, anyway, this one page turned into a 14-page document from the county attorney. And we worked on that 14-page document, and we haven't been able to resolve the issues that are between the city and county on this. Under the 25-year agreement, any improvements that were made for the benefit of the users, they had an obligation to pay a portion of that improvement. The City of Cumming billed Forsyth County, invoiced Forsyth County in February this year for $11,400,000 for their portion of that, and the city has not received payment. With the county working under a contract and a permit from EPD, the county's permit was 14 million gallons a day. We're not obligated under the permit, because the contract expired, to furnish the county that raw water. So I'm going to request and recommend to the board that as of October the 1st of this year, that we terminate the raw water portion of the county. And all the water that the county will receive, which will be all they'll need, we'll furnish all the water the county needs. We're not going to cut them out. They'll come through the treated water facility of the City of Cumming at $2.50 a thousand gallon, beginning October the 1st. This is an enterprise system, and we have to make it stand a foot above water. We can't let the system lose money. So my recommendation is what I presented, and what's the pleasure of the board. It'll be starting October the first will be $2.50 a thousand gallon for treated water. But all water will be discontinued based on the fact that it's illegal now for the city maybe to be pumping water since the county don't have a contract with the city for that permit. Have a motion. Motion for Rath. Have a second. Second for John Day. In discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Items for consideration and discussion. Citizen or water contracts. County attorney.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, the first item on this meeting was something I think we were going to consider taking up the last work session, and we tried to add it to the agenda. The thought was, let's go ahead and have a special call meeting, which is today, to talk about the city county water contracts. I think I don't need to say to the board that at the present time, we do not have a city county raw or finished water contract. We have not had one since roughly May 26th of 2012, right now, I think I've completed the directions of the board with respect to my interaction with the city to try and get a contract or secure a contract based upon the terms. The last, delivery would have been the interim. Remember the interim IGA? That would have been the last delivery, and that has been rejected by the city. So at this point, I am looking for any additional direction from the Board of Commissioners with respect to how you want to move forward.
Does anyone have any information or new proposals they'd like to bring forward at this time?
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to recuse myself from any vote and discussion before we start any discussion this matter.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Does anybody have any comments about the water contract?
I will, if nobody else does. Does anyone else have any?
I don't at this time.
I just want to clear up some this knowledge as well. I'd like to go through just so the public truly understands the days that passed from the day that this board voted on the binding agreement which became a bullet point that went over to the city. And the reason why I feel this is necessary is because it seems the mayor has told the public and they put it on page news that in fact what made it fall apart was a 14-page IGA that we created. Well, in fact, it was their 14-page IGA that was created, not ours. And I'd like to go through those. I have given, I don't know, who else here with the media? Anybody else? Okay, anyway, of course, that's news, got it. It just lays out each IGA that went back and forth. Once the vote went through, there's a copy of our vote. You sure can. Anybody else? Because I know the Board of Commissioners, have gotten us through client privilege with our attorneys. Most all of it, if you just want the back part, it might make it easier on you guys because you already have the rest of the emails.
Yeah, that's why I should have it.
Okay, fair enough. Well, you got it in the back part.
Oh, it's here?
Yeah, it is. And anyways, it just goes basically through the first letter that was sent over by our county. And Ken, this came from Doug Dare, if you want to go through that for a moment, please.
We have two public comment speakers signed up this evening. Our first speaker is Julian Bowen.
It's bad when you walk 20 feet and think you've done something. There's two things I'd like to talk to you about, but before I do that, I want to congratulate Brian Tam for getting elected for the third time as District 2 Commissioner, and only one of the first has ever been elected more than that to the Board of Commissioners. And I'd like to congratulate Jim Boff for getting re-elected as the sitting chairman. Never in my memory, goes back to 1980, that a sitting chairman has been re-elected. And of course, with over 62% of the vote, that's something to be proud of. The first thing I'd like to talk to you about is the water contract. And after the situation we found ourselves in now, there's almost no way that the board and the council can come together on this. You have a signed letter of agreement, and really the best thing is for both the county and city to go before a visiting Superior Court judge and let him fill in the details of what that is. it's going to be a situation, if you try to put all the finished water through that one water plant, that's going to be a massive increase, and you're going to put public safety at risk if that's done. You can have a pipe that ruptured. I imagine the pressure is going to have to be increased because it's all going to be coming out of one area instead of the other plant. And you could have a fire with no water pressure in the county. And then, of course, it's just aggravating for people not to have water pressure. And there's no hard feelings. And I've talked to the mayor many times over the past, 15 years. And we've worked on a lot of things together. And I understand it's tough for the county to be so big and dominant that, and you gotta also look at the situation on age. I'm 65 years old, and I'm an old man. And I can tell it every time I walk. If I was on the city council, I'd be the youngest man by 6 years. These guys have put a lot of time and effort in their public service, and they're tired, and they make mistakes. And there was a reason why Bear Bryant was forced to retire from the University of Alabama when he was 70. There's a cutoff point in which a man has to step back from the forefront of what's going on in the community. And these people are trying their best, and it's no fault of their own. So you've got to understand that a Superior Court judge, a visiting Superior Court judge, can fill in the details of the contract and do this in a situation where there's no more animosity. Now, the second thing I'd like to talk about is the local option sales tax. I came over to Forsyth County for the first time in 1968 or 1969. I can't remember what day it was. For a basketball game. I'd already graduated from high school. My girlfriend was a cheerleader, and I was riding the school bus. And I was amazed at how the community was. The local option sales tax is something that you need to seriously think about. Fire protection is the number one responsibility with law enforcement of an incorporated municipality. And without a fire department per se, the city of Cumming is caught up basically to where they should be.
Wayne, can you hold on for a second? Do we wish to grant more time? Is that exceptional? About how much more time? How much more time do you think you might need?
Not very much. I'm about finished.
A minute?
A minute would be fine. I'm sorry to run over. I don't have a prepared speech. Okay. The other thing that I was mentioning is there has to be a phasing out. If a community, a city, does not have a paid fire department, and that's one of the prime reasons for having a city, and we have a county fire department that's paid for separately and administrated separately. The local option sales tax, you have to get away from the actual numbers, and you have to go back to what each project that would fund. And there's been a lot of, and what's really, really disturbing is no talking between the council and the commission. When the 77 acres was bought on Pilgrim Mill Road recently, and John Hurd didn't have a real reason to buy the property. We've been through the water plant acquisitions and things like that in Coa when I was growing up, and you don't move a water plant. That's just something that doesn't happen. So you're looking at a sewer plant on Pilgrim Mill Road, and we have so much sewer capacity that it's almost impossible to think that has to be done quickly. And I've overrun my time, and I'm sorry. Congratulations once again. It's always good to have people get elected. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Our next speaker is Hal Schneider.
Good evening, Commissioners. My name is Hal Schneider. I am a resident of Forsyth County, and I'm here speaking for myself only. As you all are well aware, the mayor has threatened to turn off the supply of raw water to the county as of October 1. That's a little more than 3 weeks from today. While I applaud the concept of bringing in a judge to fill in the details of the contract, I don't think that's going to happen in 3 weeks. And we have a crisis on our hands on the 1st of October. I would strongly urge this commission during item 3 of old business, which was added to the agenda today, to
present, vote on, and approve a motion to petition the court for an injunction restraining the mayor from turning off the water on October 1. As Julian mentioned, this is and could be a serious public safety issue we have. Secondly, I would like to reiterate a request that I've made a couple times before, that any commissioner that has a conflict because of business that they are doing with the city or their spouse is doing business with the city should recuse themselves from any negotiations on the water contract. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Is there anyone who wishes to speak in favor of the proposed amendments to the Forsyth County Ethics Ordinance?
Good evening, Commissioners. Well, that's a nice ties y'all are wearing. I think it's casual even for the rest of the world out here. My name's Brent Meadows. I have a little bit of experience with ethics. I, like Commissioner Tam, had an ethics complaint filed and subsequently it was dismissed for technical errors. I'm a little bit concerned that we're going to remove the ability of this board to do an investigation on their own. If there is a proposal or a complaint that's made and it's dismissed on technical errors, I think that the panel should be able to make a determination. Well, the technical errors here do prevent us from moving ahead, but we see something and we want to investigate further, and then their hands would be tied. So I think that that's very important for you to do that. Hold on 1 second. No, Mr. Mayor, I can't tell them that. But other than that, I'm in favor of this ordinance, and I hope that you'll consider a passage with a few modifications to allow that board to be able to do some further investigations if they deem necessary because of some technical deficiencies. Thank you.
Well, good timing. Why don't you come on up here and tell these folks where we are.
Those of you that don't know, this is Jim Barney, the chairman of the Board of Commissioners here in the county.
So welcome.
Thank
Glad
you.
You're here.
Thanks for being here.
Appreciate
Absolutely.
It.
Absolutely. I guess we're here talking about water.
We are.
With a high cost level. According to what the mayor said on October the 1st, he'll turn off the raw water, any raw water that the county gets, and will provide only finished water. If that happens October 1st, and October 1st historically is like other Octobers where we will be short of water for the county. Now, short of water has a couple of implications. One, of course, is that possibly some people won't have water. The other is maybe not quite that drastic. People will have low pressure, possibly. If there's a fire, possibly there are fire hydrants which won't have the right amount of pressure. Another thing that happens is if he's going to provide us all of the finished water, if he were able to do that, which he can't because he doesn't have a permit to do it,
right?
He doesn't have a treatment plant to do it, and if you have those other two things, he doesn't have the pipe capacity to us to provide us that much water. So our assumption is that he would provide as much as he could, and that would increase either the flow rate or the pressure in the pipes, which would scour the pipes. Can potentially damage them, but also, as you can imagine, over time there's stuff that builds up in pipes that could shake that loose and may discolor the water. You might be doing your laundry and all of a sudden your clothes come out red, is the color that I'm told.
Yep.
That's the position we're currently in right now.
The two commissioners that are voting against seeking an injunction are Patrick Bell and Brian Tam.
Gosh, I'm
okay.
Why is the one vote recused though? What's
Pete Amos, Pete Amos owns a water company and buys water directly from the city and resells it to like four or five subdivisions.
And it's supposed to
He's in District 1, which is basically the city. Yeah. He represents the city also.
If this were to be done, if the water being turned off were to be done by, let's say, the Middle Eastern Arab Land Development Corporation, we would probably call this a terrorist act, wouldn't we?
Well, I will say this, the mayor...
Could very well be.
The mayor certainly wrote to the Corps of Engineers when they were seeking to rewrite their operations manual for the lake under the Judge Magnuson ruling.
And in that letter, the mayor said, A, that to rewrite the manual would be reckless, and he said it would be a threat to the health, safety, and welfare of both Forsyth County and the City of Cummings. So, because rewriting that manual would have been a rewrite under Magnuson of providing no water for drinking out of the lake. So he saw it that way under those circumstances, and I can't speak for him as to why he doesn't see it that way under these circumstances.
Who here lives in District 1?
I guess I do.
Okay, you know where you get your water from? From the city. It's not going to affect you.
Not going to affect you at all.
Who lives in District 3? Okay, well, District 3, you get a lot of your water from the city. It's not going to affect you. District 5, how many in District 5? What, half or more of your water comes from the city. It's not going to affect you. What two districts are going to be most affected by the cutoff of water or an increase in water rates?
Two and four.
And who represents 2 and 4?
Brian and Patrick.
Who's not representing their constituents?
Isn't that amazing?
That is amazing. No, that's
well, you also have to consider that Brian Tam has a lease for his restaurant with the City of Cumming. Okay,
yeah.
So he's not going to do anything that's going to upset the balance for his lease. So.
He's got a great deal on the lease.
Oh, it's an outstanding deal.
Okay, but actually, he doesn't have that. It's in his wife's name. Brian
well,
is totally divorced from it. So,
that's a technical.
Yeah, right.
Except he gets his income. Leave that.
LLC called Schoolhouse Holdings LLC. It's not his wife personally. It's in a corporate entity.
Which has not paid their registration dues for this year, correct?
Indeed, yes, sir.
Ron.
Jim, now, you know, I just strongly feel the mayor's not going to turn this off October 1st because you can't just discard the health of people that live in District 2 and 4 and those of us in 5 that are on county water. So something's going to happen. I mean, the mayor, in my take, is going to back down. He's going to come along with some kind of a compromise that does give him a lot of revenue that he doesn't deserve, but is going to look better than shutting off the water on October 1st. And Tam and Bell are going to try to be the heroes by saying, look, we helped avoid this catastrophe that was fostered on the county. Okay? Now, you mentioned some kind of write-up, an injunction. I assume that also takes 3 votes from the Board of Commissioners to get that started.
Sure.
Otherwise, I would say, why don't we get that started now and have it ready to go, right?
Yes. I think direction from the chairman could direct the county attorney to
get started?
Prepare a contingency.
See, if you can do that, it seems to me like we ought to get that going now and have it ready to go in case we do face this deadline. Although I don't, in any stretch of the imagination, think that the mayor's going to turn the water off. But he is going to play it. He's also going to play it into the local option sales tax negotiations that are going on right now. He's going to try to work. I'm going to give you this deal on water if you give me 15% of the local option sales tax where he deserves 3 or 4, okay?
That's right.
The city has at least, call it 3 tiers. If you live inside the city limits, you pay the least for your water.
Right.
People on the county pay the most. So in other words, my way of seeing it is that county people are subsidizing people who live either in the city or just outside the city.
I agree. Instead of us all paying a share of the cost evenly.
Instead of us all getting the lowest cost possible.
The 1987 agreement that was signed with the city, between the city and the county, included a large percentage of the special purpose local option sales tax at that time to go to the city water system. I think it was like 37%. The county has made that investment in the water system. Later on, when there was a withdrawal taken from the lake, the county paid part of that withdrawal cost. And in addition, the county's been paying high water rates all these years. So the county has had a big investment in the city water system. That supports your argument, I think, that says that we shouldn't be paying much more than what it costs to deliver the water to the county because we've made the investments along with the city. The mayor will say, this is our system, we've made the investment, therefore we can charge you whatever we want, right? And by the way, we're charging one of the lowest rates of any of the counties around. I mean, that's his story. We've made investments in that. His story doesn't hold up, even if it was reasonable. Okay.
the EPD is part of the problem here in that the City of Cumming has a permit to withdraw more water for, call it 5,000 people, than we have to withdraw for now 170, 175,000 people. So the EPD, by not doing a reasonable regulation of the need to the entities that can draw water, has not served us well.
Back when I was on the board, EPD refuses a permit to withdraw water from Lake Lanier. And my impression at the time is that the mayor had a lot of influence on EPD. The director of EPD at the time, Harold Rehise, told me that you've got a contract with the city to buy water from them. My reaction was, that's none of your business. That's not EPD's business, that's between the city and the county. We then went to King and Spaulding and hired King and Spaulding to take legal action against EPD. Shortly thereafter, EPD decided they would give the county a permit to withdraw. Then we subsequently got tied up in this tri-state water war where no one could get additional water. So that cut that off. But I'm just telling you, before we had to hire King and Spaulding, I think it was Pat Barmeyer was our attorney from King and Spaulding, and we may have to do the same thing again.
So here's one of the things that, you know, you really need to consider. And it's something that Jim and I have talked about this a little bit. Ron, you probably, you know, may have a different opinion on it. But, you know, now is the time to start talking to, I hate to say Jack Murphy for all it's worth, which isn't a whole lot, you know, but, you know, our local representatives, we need to be talking to the governor, sending him letters, because what he's got to realize, this is a Republican, you know, county. You know, if this county were to lose its water, you know, because of an inaction on behalf of Nathan Deal and Casey Cagle and some of the legislative leaders from this county, you know, I'd hate to think that, you know, we put Democrats back in office, but, you know, maybe we might put a few Tea Party and some Libertarians in their place. Somebody who might actually listen, you know, to the citizens of the county and not pay attention to that 25 people in this county that tend to control the activities. I mean, it's, you know, it's kind of a, Jim's talked to the governor. I mean, I haven't talked to Nathan, but I did deal with Sonny, and we've all talked to EPD, and you know, it's just a thing, the wind isn't blowing because it goes in one ear and comes out the other. It's amazing if you light a cigarette, see the smoke pass through. But I mean, you know, the thing about it, this is, you know, we've got to get beyond Brian Tam and Patrick Bell, because, you know, we've really got to get it to a higher level. Because I honestly, yeah, I would rather see the mayor go ahead and shut the water off, because I think that would be the best thing that could happen for this county.
Amen.
Because, you know, then, and I said, that's kind of up to Jim and Todd Levent that, to though. Resist.
He knows that.
Well, I know that. But yeah. To resist efforts to deal with this amazing compromise, you know, plan that they're going to come up with. No, let's let it go the full nine yards. You know, let's let it end up in court. And it's got to. I mean, whether they'll take action or not, I feel fairly certain that the state, and it's on its own behalf, would take action, because they're not going to let 173,000 Republicans go without water to satisfy, you know, a few diehard Democrats.
We have on the agenda for next Thursday night, Todd Levent and I put it on the agenda in open session, not executive session, in open session. At this point, it remains to have a vote as to whether to move for an injunction to stop the city from turning off the water.
What's the best thing for all of us to do?
I think we should be sending emails and letters to, you know, the head of the EPD, the mayor, the governor,
Mark
and commissioners that you disagree, you think to disagree with their position. Mike Dudgeon,
Mark,
newspapers,
Mark Hamilton.
I will say this,
Jack
Mike
Murphy.
Mike Dudgeon, to me, you know, in I'll call him private phone calls, and he's actually written some things in the newspaper. Mike Dudgeon definitely seems to have the most sympathy for the idea that people should have to pay any more for a commodity like water, which belongs to the state. The mayor says he has no debt, none. He says that he spent $35 million on a new sewer treatment plant a couple of years ago, still no debt. He says he spent $17 to $18 million on the water intake, still no debt. He wants us to pay around $11 to $12 million for our share of the new water intake, which would be, you know, money that he has coming in, plus the $4 to $5 million in revenue for water a year, plus money for the SPLOST, a percentage of the SPLOST, plus percentage for the loss. But I can't know for sure, but I would guess that he's got $15, $20 million in the bank. Well, that's great, good for him. But he's got the money in the bank because the county goes in debt for its water service.
Well, and because he's been getting a disproportionate share of the loss and the SPLOST and this water revenue. As you're pointing out, no debt and no city property tax.
Yeah,
so where is he getting the money?
He's getting it all from
services. The county.
From the county.
I think Ron was right when he said that what will happen is at the 11th hour, there will be a miraculous save, you know, angels in the outfield, you know, will appear to two commissioners and they'll come forth with a miraculous plan that will cost the citizens of the county, you know, some additional amount of money, probably put us more in debt in the city, but it will get us out of this, you know, this morass that, you know, Jim and Ron and myself have put us in over the years by, you know, not getting down and kissing the mayor's ring. So I'll say something else.
Well, you know, I will say this.
Jim, you've been here long enough, and Ron knows this, I know this, Jim Harrell standing right there knows this. Until the water doesn't drip out of the faucet or brown water flows out of the faucet, 98% of the people in this county are going to say, I don't really give a damn.
Yeah.
You know, that's the only thing that will wake people up is when actually it is something that directly, immeasurably affects them. Otherwise, you know, they don't care. They don't know what's going on.
That's how the mayor's been able to get by with all this disproportionate money all these years, just because the voters don't get involved and don't care that much about the deal.
The unfortunate thing, truly, though, is someone who can credibly and will threaten to turn off the water as a negotiation tactic. To me, that is not good faith.
Yeah, I agree with that.
No, absolutely. No.
Well, Mayor, you never had anything in good faith, in my view. All the stuff I've been involved with between the city and the county over all these years, he's never done anything in good faith. Never.
How old is he?
He will be 71 in December.
Health-wise.
And he's been mayor for
40 years. 42 years, 43 years, something like that.
So, I mean, he has all his faculties.
And most of the members of the city council have been there for, you know, 25 plus years as well.
That's a good old one.
Yeah.
Yep. Well,
it's interesting, if you ever go to a city hall meeting, it's interesting to watch the voting, because the mayor will call for a vote, he sits in the middle, everybody's off to the sides, right? He calls for a vote, he's looking down at his papers, he says, everybody who agrees, raise your right hand, or raise your hand. He's not even looking. He doesn't even look at the city how they vote. And he says, unanimous. I mean, the eyes have it, it's unanimous. It
gives you the impression they might have a pre-meeting.
I thought he did everything behind closed doors too, so you can actually.
Well, who knows what goes on? You know, like Ron. Yeah, like Ron was saying, who knows what goes on before their meetings? But even their meetings are just rubber stamp. I mean, there's no
never
conversation. There's never the same vote. He's using this as a negotiating tactic, and we just need to make sure that we don't cave in. It's blackmail, as far as I'm concerned.
No, actually, it's extortion.
Well, if we have to pay the higher rates, it will be extortion. That's correct. I agree with that.
I have a request raw water to the county from October the 1st to October the 31st. And since our last meeting, when the council voted to furnish the county water through our treatment plant rather than out of Lake Lanier raw water intake, several things has happened. One in particular, Chairman Boff had written a letter on behalf of himself as commissioner and asked the governor, the attorney general maybe, the Corps of Engineers, Josh Turner, EPD, maybe Representative Mark Hamilton, Senator Murphy, to maybe try to intervene because of the potential safety issues or health issues, I believe was stated in the request. We don't think that's going to happen, that there would be a safety issue or a health issue. Whenever we started construction of the intake in Lake Lanier, we had designs with civil engineering company, and this project was a comprehensive, in-depth project, and it included putting a 3,000-foot line out into Lake Lanier at the 1017 level. That's the deepest intake in Lake Lanier. Had we not done that, the city and county would be taking extreme measures, or the city would be taking extreme measures now to furnish water to their citizens coming in from South County. The city paid for all of this. When it's all said and done, 24 months, it was done, 2010 turned over to us. It was a $17 million ticket. Part of that ticket was to put in infrastructure that furnished the Antioch treatment plant. Over $500,000 went just for one line from Lake Lanier Shores, the pump station, to Pilgrim Mill Road, hooked on to the master line that went to Antioch plant for the county. Over $500,000 for that one line. February this year, we sent the county a bill for their portion under the contract that expired May the 26th of this year for 65% of that $17 million, which was $11.4 million. Today, we haven't received payment to show that good faith of the city in trying to work things and resolve things. Commissioner Boff, Commissioner Tam has, at his request, recommended extension of this cutting off the county raw water for 30 days. I would recommend to the council that we honor Commissioner Tam's request, and during that period of time, during that 30 days. One of the things that I would request our distribution department to do would be to work with its counterpart of the county production part of the water and max out our treated water to the county and see what kind of issues that comes up. See if we have a safety issue or a health issue during that 30-day period. My recommendation to the county, to the city, is that we kick the can down the road, so to speak, for another 30 days to try to resolve the issue, even though at our last meeting, the council voted to start the transition of the city's treated water on October the 1st. So, Chair, will entertain a vote to that, and I'll say a few other words in reference to it in just a minute. Okay, I have a motion from Ralph that we extend the raw water cutoff from October the 1st to October the 31st. I have a second. In discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Now, this comes to the next issue under announcements. We have, through our attorney, Dan Miles, and the county's attorney, Kim Rod, they have been working on the required mediation of lost sales tax. That is one of the reasons that my recommendation to extend this 30 days that we can case and mediate and talk about the water during the loss, provided the council agrees with it. The mediation of the lost sales tax is October the 15th and 16th. I believe that's the scheduled date that's been agreed upon by the two councils, the city and county. Now, it's my recommendation to the board that we discuss the lost sales tax and then we work on discussing the water in the mediation process. And they've come in that order of lost and then the water. So the chairman will entertain a motion that we mediate the lost sales tax October the 15th and 16th of the next month, which is October 15th and 16th. That's a Monday and a Tuesday. So, chair, entertain a motion for that. Have a motion from John Day to have a second.
Mr. Mayor, did you mean to include loss followed by water? You didn't say that in the motion. I just want to correct that to make sure.
We'll discuss loss followed by water.
Yes, sir. You just didn't say that in the motion. You said it in your discussion, not the motion. I just want to clarify what the motion request was.
You're correct. Thank you. Thank you.
Excuse me for interrupting.
And the minutes. The minutes will reflect that. And that is. That is what we will send Commissioner Tam. He'll have the authority to bring this up with the commissioners for this discussion, which will be the loss and the water in that order on October the 15th and the 16th. So the chair will entertain a motion to have a motion and a second. Dundee made a motion. Who made a second? Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay. Commissioner Boff, I see Commissioner Levent, Commissioner Bale. I see y'all have a quorum here. I hope you're not illegal, but have a quorum. But listen, you know, these things are not easy. If it was, probably they'd already been done. Done when we started on it 6 years ago. I think we started working on it with maybe Commissioner Lackenhouse, or maybe before. But like I said, we would like to get it resolved and worked out. But keep in mind, the City of Cumming water system and sewer system is an enterprise system. And we have 17,000 customers, and the county has over 40,000. And the county's budget is lots more. I'll not get into numbers because sometimes I get wrong. This is an enterprise system, and we represent the citizens, these 17,000 customers. We're trying to keep it out of date, and we've been able to do that so far. But out of the emergency fund and the reserve, we were able to pay for the $17 million. We depleted our funds on that. So,
our next speaker is Hal Schneider.
My name is Hal Schneider. I'm here representing myself and other organizations. And I am a resident of Forsyth County. I gotta tell you, I was really disappointed to hear
discussion of the injunction from the agenda tonight. By postponing it to October 18th, you put yourself into kind of a bind if mediation doesn't work out on October 16th. You'll have 2 weeks before the water gets shut off if it's not resolved in mediation. That's not a lot of time to get an injunction in place. Getting an injunction in place would have removed a potential disruption of the raw water supply to the county. It also would have removed that as a threat during your negotiations and your mediation. The mayor's plan to increase or to remove the raw water supply and supply all of the treated water to the county increases exponentially the risk to the county, because you now have not just one single point of failure, namely the intake and the pipe coming up where it splits off to the county plant. You now have the city's water plant and a whole lot more of the city's infrastructure that are now a potential point of failure, which would cause a cutoff of water to the entire county. I think this is a risky plan. Not only that, but if the city provides all the water, you're going to essentially be mothballing the Antioch plant. You're going to shut it down. I don't know what the consequences of doing that are. You know, that kind of equipment usually doesn't do well when you turn it off and then later turn it back on. So you have risk of issues with the Antioch plant when you bring it back online, if you ever bring it back online. The Board of Commissioners needs to stand firm during mediation. The county would best serve to wait until January and let the new dynamics of the board come into play as Cindy Mills replaces Patrick Bell on the board. The county should refuse to participate in this testing that the mayor proposed, because that's just a ploy for the mayor to increase his revenues during the month of October by selling a whole lot more treated water to the county. It would be foolish for the Board of Commissioners to commit to anything until the pending EPD permits have been resolved. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, if I might, Mr. Snyder, I typically try not to address citizens during public comments because it is your time to give your thoughts, but this is an issue that's of vital importance to our community.
I agree.
And I just want to clarify the comments about the water being shut off, the scare tactics of risk to our citizens. I just want to clarify to you that this board's not going to allow that to happen. The mayor's not going to allow that to happen. The water's not going to be shut off. That's a term that you've coined. What is going to happen, from what I understand, which I'm fully prepared that we'll come to an agreement, but what's going to happen is they're not going to be able to provide raw water, which our permit, to my knowledge, is issued that says that we can have raw water as long as we have an agreement with the city to pump it. So mainly what I want to clarify is, you know, you've coined this term that the mayor's going to shut off the water. And that's not going to happen. There is going to be no risk to our citizens. The council and the mayor.
You can guarantee that the city's water infrastructure can handle the entire supply for the county and the city. You're going to guarantee that, Mr.
No, sir. I'm not going to guarantee it.
That's a dangerous gamble for you to make.
I can tell you that I have more knowledge and more experience in this that you do, and I can tell you that the city's not going to allow that to happen. And if it does look like it's going to happen, I can assure you the mayor will turn the raw water back on.
Right. After the Antioch plant has been turned off, how long does it take to bring it back
on? I'm not talking about that issue. I'm just telling you that I'm tired of people saying
turning the raw water back on after the Antioch plant is not.
Would you let me have three minutes?
Yeah, but you're not even supposed to be making comments during public.
Well, I can speak whenever I want to on the commission.
Not if the board doesn't approve it.
So, the fact of the matter is,
nobody's going to shut the conversation. All those, is there a second?
The fact of the matter is, Mr. Schneider, you can call the city is not going to cut the water off. They're not going to put our citizens at risk. Yes, there's a disagreement. Yes, it's going to be expensive. All those kind of things are true. But please quit trying to scare the citizens with these tactics. Thank you.
Please tell us why the mayor would turn off the raw water. What's the purpose? What is the purpose of turning off the raw water? It's to increase the revenue to the city. That's what it's all about.
I'm telling you that I'm tired of people saying that, that the city, the council, and the mayor are going to are creating a health and safety hazard.
There's a potential hazard.
There's a potential for anything.
And the city's infrastructure has never pumped that much water.
I make a motion to end this conversation.
Thank you.
Our next speaker is Rebecca Ricks.
And I want to speak strictly to the fact that we have commissioners on the board that's family or themselves could do any business with the city. And we need for those people to recuse themselves, because what has happened, they are benefiting on the water negotiations, on the loss negotiations, because they do have a relationship with them. Either their family does or they do personally. And I would appreciate it if these people and you gentlemen on the board would please start representing the voters of this county and not yourselves. You need to recuse yourself when it comes to votes on the WASC, on the water, anything else that has to do with negotiations with the city. Thank you.
Our next speaker is Rebecca Ricks.
Personal interest in pending matter, except as a citizen.
Gentlemen, I have discovered a terrorist cell operating in the midst of Forsyth County. And it's operating right under your noses, or more accurately, right across the street. This terrorist organization doesn't have some scary name like Al-Qaeda or the Taliban. They go by the moniker, the City of Cumming government. Now, far be it from me to be accused of fear-mongering by a certain member of this august body, but the naivete of at least one of your members, if not two, is rather startling. The terrorist cell leader has proclaimed that as of a certain date, his cell is going to arbitrarily raise the rate they charge this county for finished water, and will deny Forsyth County raw water for us to finish ourselves. Now, the other five members of that terror cell could have stopped their chief from imposing this reign of terror, but that group of myrmidons hasn't had an independent thought since they popped out of the womb and exclaimed, "Oh, look, light." As with everything in life, some people get things and what's going to happen, and some people are just clueless. The simple way to figure out which is to ask the only question needed to be answered. What if we don't give in to the terrorists? Because the answer to that not only settles the fear-mongering question, but gives the four of you who can vote on this, even if one of you shouldn't, the course of action. You see, if you do as Nancy Reagan once suggested and just say no, there are two courses the terrorist chieftain can take: raise your rates or cut off your water supply. If he raises your rates, you have two choices: pay them or don't pay them. So you have to ask yourselves this question. If you truly believe that the terror cell operating across the street won't cut off your water supply when you refuse to pay their confiscatory rates, why are you even bothering to negotiate with them? And if you do believe they'll cut off the water, then the charge of fear-mongering takes on a whole new reality now, doesn't it? If we've learned anything since 9/11, you don't negotiate with terrorists. You just need to know how to whack them. And in this civilized nation, the only way to whack them is through the court system. If you haven't been told by now that every legal precedent favors giving those who paid significant sums to maintain and upgrade infrastructure at least partial ownership rights, you should have been. That intake is partially ours by reason of our payments to that terror cell through the decades it's been in existence. And if you simply have the testicular fortitude to take that stand in court, you stand a good chance of ending this reign of terror once and for all. I know two of you don't have it in you to represent the interests of Forsyth County over the interests of that terror cell. So my remaining comments are for the two who still do. Don't cave. Stand firm on this until help arrives in January of next year, when objectivity replaces capitulation and reason replaces appeasement. If three of you can't get together to whack this terror cell in the next few months, then two of you need to hold down the fort until reinforcements arrive. This is a battle you cannot afford to lose.
Our next speaker is Dr. Joe Moses.
Two among your number should vote.
I have commissioned legal counsel to investigate thoroughly the issue of conflict of interest of those commissioners who have direct business relations with the city. The kind of financial connections with the city that unduly influence a vote because of business interests. All of which undermines independent judgment in the best interest of the citizens of the county. We intend to pursue the issue of conflicts of interest to its conclusion unless these two commissioners who have immediate financial interests deeply connected to the city recuse themselves from voting on the water issue and the lost issue with the city. OCG 4510-3, our state statute, sets forth a code of ethics for the county commissioners. It mandates subsection 9 that a county commissioner shall never take any official action with regard to any matter under circumstances in which he knows or should know that he has a direct or indirect monetary interest in the subject matter of such matter or in the outcome of such official action. If the commissioner violates this code, then OCG code 4510-4 will be triggered, which, if followed through and you're found guilty, you will be removed from office by the board. Furthermore, Supreme Court case law shows that a commissioner who has a financial interest connected.
Time is up. Does anyone wish to extend the time? Make a motion to give it 10 more minutes.
Go along with 30 seconds to a minute.
How about a minute? We have a motion for a minute. And
second.
There's no discussion, please vote. Sorry.
Thank you.
That's interesting. That might show the two people he was not talking about.
That was our final speaker, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Jody.
Good evening, gentlemen. My name is Rebecca Wicks. I'm a Forsyth County resident. I'm here just becoming myself. As I'm sure you're all aware, I'm going to speak one more time on conflict of interest. And I've been reading from you in the past couple of meetings on the Georgia Mini Code, Forsyth County Georgia Mini Code, that explains, because obviously we have a problem with people understanding conflict of interest, that conflict of interest means any employee, any elected official that has a wife, child, son, whatever, blood, marriage, interest in a business that is profiting from another portion. And this would be the Cumming, the City of Cumming. And we do have that on our board. It's important in reading this that the commissioners that have that conflict of interest man up and recuse yourself.